know about our Father in the Lord, the General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, even as it turns 80 on March 2nd, 2022. 80 good years, 80 years of impactfulness, 80 years of excellent service to humanity and to God at large. So I'm not here alone. I have somebody. Hello, Shayo.
Hello, Sabrina. Hello, Sabrina. It's amazing to be here.
Yeah.
You're someone I very much look up to.
Yeah. Come on. I'm sitting close to a superstar.
It's a wonderful privilege to be here. Yeah.
Hi, how are you doing?
Very well, thank you.
Are you excited?
Yes, I am.
All right, so tell the world.
Okay, so like she said, I'm Olusayo, and for the next 8 wonderful days, we'll be talking about our Father in the Lord. Pastor E.A ADEBOYE is an icon, is a beacon of light. And we want you to know that these 8 days, you mustn't miss any of them, because each day we'll be going deep and deeper into his life and telling you wonderful facts about him. Thank you.
All right. So facts, like he said, Shaya said it. So we have 10 facts each day. For today, you will not believe what I want to say or what we are here to tell you. It's going to be so amazing. And we have series of sessions. We have praise and worship. We also have the social media segment. So all of you that are not on the social media platform, so right now, grab your phone and join the massive community here on Dove Television, on Facebook at Dove Television, tweet at Dove TV to just tell us. And the hashtag is E.A ADEBOYE at 80. Hashtag. All right, so get ready, E.A.A., right?
Yes, E.A.A.
at 80. So get ready, and we are just here. So to kickstart this, let's take the praise and worship by Dare Akinyebi. We'll be right back after the praise and worship segment. Stay tuned.
The old man.
Come on, lift your voice and give God praise wherever you are. Exalt the name of Jesus. He's worthy to be praised. There is none like him. He's our King. He's our Maker. He's the lover of our soul. We lift you, our God. We lift you, our God. We bless you for your faithful, your good, your kind, your loving. Hallelujah. 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 Jesus, we give you praise, oh God. Hey, madam, my horse, you are not my God. Hey, we give you praise, God. We give you praise, God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah to you, God. Hallelujah to you, God. Oh, we give you glory. As we worship you, we give you glory, Lord, and we honor you, 'cause you are wonderful. You are worthy, oh Lord. You are wonderful. Hey, you are worthy, oh Lord. You come see you, come see you, cause any toad I be red, cause any toad I be red, cause see you, lie at the room, cause see you, hey, cause any toad I be red, cause any toad. We say, lift your voice and say, Cosio. Nobody, not like you, Jesus. You were the first and the last, the beginning and the end. Say, Cosio. Yeah. Cause any thought of you, nobody like you, no compares to you. Hey, cause any thought of you, oh Jesus. your life, Jesus. We thank God for what God has done so far. He's gonna do so much more in this new season. In this new season. Eba Kosha, say you will help me. Say you will help me in the past. You will help me again.
You will help me again.
Oh,
you will help me in the past.
You will help me again.
Oh, so we stand bold to testify of God's good works in the life of our father, Pastor E.A ADEBOYE. What an amazing worship session by Minister Dari Akinyemi. Oh, I believe our spirits were edified. Praise God. So now we'll go into the facts. The first fact. Oh, I'm excited, Abby. I'm excited too. I want you to get your pen. There may or may not be a gift at the end of this. So you need to get your pen, get your jotters, call your friends to tune into Dove TV right now, because we are getting into those facts and they are very juicy. The first fact, Daddy G.O. was born on the 2nd of March, 1942. I'm sure so many people don't know the exact day.
Yeah.
So today, you know the exact day that Daddy G.O. was born, 2nd of March, 1942.
Woo!
Sabrina.
Drum roll, 2nd of March, 1942. What was it?
Oh my goodness.
<You're> not... No, I just watched
you, you know this joke where they say children will sit, we were sitting on the mat somewhere in heaven and just waiting for our names to be called and then and oh, then being dispatched
you know,
to our parents.
My friend told me that, so I literally have, so there's this fact about me too, that I have a long hair. So my friends that don't have long hair, they said, who were on the queue, that me, when they've not even called my name, maybe they called my grandmother's name, I ran forward. So 1942, maybe it was that period I ran forward.
Oh, that's when you got the air, then you went back to sit down. Amazing.
And I was born in early 90s. Anyways, I won't tell you my age.
Oh, okay.
Before people will come and be looking at me. But anyways, Daddy was born on 2nd of March. Thank
yes,
you for that.
1942.
All right, so... For all the people in Osun State, what state are you from, Shai?
Oyo State. It's not so far. The beautiful thing is that Osun State actually came out of Oyo State. Yeah, so maybe in some way or the other we are related.
Wow. No wonder I look like you're even looking like Daddy G.O. somehow. Because you're tall.
It's the glory of the Lord.
Okay, so the second fact is, drum roll.
Yes.
Daddy hails from Ifewara in Osun State. Osun State people. Ah, how do they greet in Osun State?
Osun State.
Mm-hmm.
So maybe the Ujasha people, which they are very close to the Ifewara people.
Okay.
They would say something like, Kuleo.
Yeah.
Yeah. There's a way they are Yoruba.
They twist it. Right.
Yes, there's a twist on their Yoruba.
Wow.
And you know the beautiful thing about Daddy G.O. hailing from this place called Ifewara? You know, he told his story about how Ifewara at the time was not even on the map of Nigeria.
Wow.
Like that. But because such a prominent man came from that place, you know, people would just be like, so we can't talk about this man and not talk about his place of origin. So Ifewara had to come on the map.
Wow. So because of just one map. So there's so many things that God is doing in our lives. And this is so beautiful because a peep into Daddy G.O.'s life or Pastor Enoch Adejare's life is for you to know that nothing is impossible with God. Wherever you are at this time, it's because of you. Maybe because of you now, they'll have to put Nigeria on the United Nations. On one thing, Sha. Don't worry. Because of you, your village that they don't know, Shayo, because of you. What village are you from in Oyo State?
I'm from Yemetu. It's in Ibadan.
Oh, really?
Yeah, Yemetu, Ibadan.
I think it's already a city or a town.
Abio, it's already a town. Our village has become a town already.
Right. But Daddy G.O. hails from Ifewara in Osun State in the southwest part of Nigeria, West Africa, the whole world. What a great man that was born. And glory be to God for the life of Daddy G.O. What about the third fact?
Hallelujah. This third one is very touching. You know, sometimes I sit back and I think about it, about how a man that has come to be this light, this beacon, had to go through rough patches in life.
Wow.
You know, he used to talk about how their family was even the poorest of the poor.
Wow.
So the third fact is that he never wore shoes until he was 18 years old.
Woo! 18 years. Wow.
So what we walk with every day was a luxury to this man.
Wow.
For a man to have moved almost all of his teenage years without wearing shoes.
Wow.
So you can imagine the kind of path that God had to take this man through.
Wow. He never wore shoes until he was 18 years old. Boop, 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 boop. I hope that's all the things you are writing there, because maybe on Wednesday, maybe on Thursday, maybe on Friday, maybe on Saturday or the last day that this peep into Daddy G.O.'s life will end on Sunday, next Sunday, maybe we may be given a gift. So why don't you just scribble this down? And when we ask the question, you can call in. If there is a grace to call in, we will. All right. So the fourth fact for all the people, did you attend the grammar school?
No, I went to a private secondary school.
Okay.
Did you attend a grammar school?
Why are you putting me on this point, Shayo? I don't like this. Anyway, let me just take a sip first before I start that question. But do you know a fact about Sabrina is the fact that she went to private schools? But you see, great things really doesn't have to start from all the luxury, right? I know of a lot of people that didn't even go to good schools, right? And they are placed at a great parastatals, placed at the top.
Very
not because of your school, but what you have in your mind or what you learned in your school.
Or seeing an opportunity and just grabbing it.
Yes. And so for DADDY G.O, one fact about him is the fact that he was admitted into Elisha Grammar School in 1956. Admitted into Elisha Grammar School in 1956. Isn't that amazing that he had to go to school? And so one beautiful thing Daddy said was the fact that when his mom wants to collect his school fees from his dad.
Oh, yeah.
She eulogizes him. He say, you killed, because his father was an hunter, right?
Yes.
His father, Daddy Gio's father, was an hunter. And so the woman will just start eulogizing her husband and say, you are the one that killed the lion. And the man will say, what time did I kill a lion? You know, but this is it. Women, if you want to get something, Shaya is married. How do your wife get things from you?
Oh, so maybe she starts rubbing my head. Yes, you have to set the mood.
Come on, tell
but,
me
But you
that.
Know the beautiful thing about that is that it also works with our God.
Okay.
So sometimes when you want to get some things from him, just talk about the things that he has done in the past. Yes.
And he will do much more.
Yes.
And he said, and Daddy said, the father would now say, oh yeah, tell me, what do you want? You say, you know your son. You are the one that gave birth to this great boy.
Mm-hmm.
And I know you want him to go to school. And Daddy said, before you know it, the man will just go and sell something just for him to go to school. And you can see the extent of which the father went, the mother went. Said there are days they will not eat, but just for him to go to school.
Sacrifice.
Shout out to all the parents out there that even though you don't have anything to eat, you still send your children to school. God bless you, and may you
reap
the fruit of your labor.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
All right, the next fact.
Oh, this one, I'm not sure if I'm worthy to talk about it. You know, the fifth fact is a powerful fact. It says that Daddy Gio got his BSc in mathematics.
Well,
not just from any school, from, I'm sure the Ife people will come for me if I don't do this very well. From the great Obafemi Awolowo University in Ife. Mathematics. Did you like mathematics
me,
in school?
Me, I never liked math. Math was never my thing in school. In fact, I don't want to open up everything because I in my WAEC, that was the West African, for people watching us all over the world, is the West African Examination Council. I never, if you know the grade I came out with, but thank God. Look at me.
Thank God for God. Thank God. We are not what we've been through.
We don't look like what we've been through.
Yeah, so for me too, mathematics was just one of those things. It was like that necessary evil you have to.
I
but
know,
the funny
right?
thing is now you have to use it in your day-to-day life.
Yeah.
So it's not something you can run away from.
Yeah, and Daddy loves mathematics. Even from his teaching.
Yes.
You know how he just breaks down
very
everything.
Systemic.
You know, very systemic, like you said. I agree. Daddy is such a great man. And he came out tops, one of the top people in mathematics from the great university of Obafemi Awolowo University in Ile Ife. Osun State, his hometown, home state, pardon me, his state of origin. He went to that same school. Did you attend your state of origin school?
Yes, I did.
Huh, my God.
So like I'm telling you, I have so many things in common with Daddy Gio.
Wow, so are you telling me that I'm sitting close to a great man? Come on.
Talk about it.
Let me collect your number now. Anyways, I have your number. Right.
So I went to University of Ibadan.
Wow.
You know, there's this unspoken rivalry between University of Ibadan and Obafemi Awolowo University.
Wow, that's amazing. Then. All right. One other thing that we want to tell you is the fact that Daddy backed Masters in Hydrodynamic in the year 1969 from the University of Lagos. In all the University of Lagos, you have someone already. He backed Masters in Hydrodynamic in the year 1969 from the University of Lagos. University of Lagos. For all the Lagosians, what is hydrodynamic? Do you have an idea?
Okay, yes, I have an idea. So hydro means water, anything that stems from water. So dynamics, of course, being of dynamic water. Is the changes, the setups, like the different spaces. And you know, the funny thing is you can actually calculate, there are a lot of calculations that go on with water, with wave systems and all of that. You know, there's something that happened the other day, a tsunami, like water, like moving out of their banks and all of that. So there are certain people that can, that went on to study how water reacts, how water moves, like even how bodies of, like things that we throw into water sometimes, you know, like waste and all of that can affect water's movement and all of that. So that's what hydrodynamics has
to do with. That is versatile, you know. From mathematics to hydrodynamics.
Yes.
Wow, that's amazing. Okay, so for those of you that don't even want to do anything with your life, I hope you are looking at it right now.
I be now.
And you are looking at it and saying to yourself that you can do all things through Christ that strengthens you, and you have to go for it. Daddy is a hard worker.
Yes.
Even at the age, he'll be 80, we can see the light up everywhere.
My goodness.
The light up.
My goodness.
Crusade all over Nigeria, even right now, it has transported, or would like to transcend to outside the country.
My
Ukraine
goodness.
Are going to have their own. Americans are going to have their own. Even in Europe, it's happening just because of one man. You can do all things. This is like a check to everyone, or like a word of encouragement to you that don't give up on your dreams. You can be everything. Just go for it, and your life will never, never remain the same. All right, even while you are talking about those things, you know, let me just crack a little bit of joke. So I said something where they said the tsunamis, like you mentioned, mm-hmm. like we have the Hurricane Katrina,
yes.
Hurricane Eunice. Somebody now said, women, only you. We don't have Hurricane.
Hurricane Michael.
We don't have Hurricane Michael. We don't have Hurricane Matthew. It's just Hurricane Katrina. Now we have Hurricane Eunice. Kilo Shele. But Daddy is, if he had gone for that, I'm sure would have had maybe Hurricane or Peace Be. Daddy doesn't come with all those vibes. It will be, you know, when the sunset is, sunset like no other,
mm-hmm.
you know, calm like no other. We'll call it calm.
Peace like a river.
Peace like a river, Daddy G.O. Amazing one. All right, so the next one, before we go into the social media segment, which we have an amazing, beautiful young lady that will be standing by. This is the last fact before we go there. But like we mentioned, they are third. So after the social media segment, we'll come back for the rest. The seventh one is, he bagged a PhD in applied mathematics in the year 1975 from the University of Lagos. He bagged a PhD in applied mathematics in the year 1975 from the University of Lagos, applied mathematics. So mm-hmm. from mathematics again.
Yes.
To apply.
Yes. So it's like the relationship between mathematics and hydrodynamics that I talked about early on.
What did you study first?
Microbiology.
No wonder you can give all these things. It's not like we the hard we are the art students. Nice. So let me hear.
But for art students too, yeah, math applies everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
Math applies everywhere. You like now we're on TV. There's a counting down,
mm-hmm.
do you understand? You can't jump in before the queue.
Mm-hmm.
That's mathematics too.
Wow.
So it's just applying mathematics to situations around you.
Awesome. So what next are we going into, Shayo?
Yeah, I wanted to talk about this because, you know, speaking of Daddy G.O, I can liken him to Daniel,
mm-hmm.
because it's like for every great man that the Lord will use, you have to train your mind first. So I'm speaking to you out there, your mind needs to be trained. You might be looking at it and saying that I don't have opportunity to go to school and all of that. But there are so many resources that you can get knowledge from. Scripture says, my people perish for lack of knowledge. So you can just look around, read about people. There are books at your disposal. The funny thing is you've not researched, but your phone can bring you into a wealth of knowledge. So maybe you should speak to yourself, speak to your mind, that mind needs to be trained so that the Lord has a field to walk with.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Shia. So quickly, we're going into the social media segment.
I'm excited.
But please get your phones. The hashtag is hashtag
E-A-A-80.
Drop all your comments, your wishes, say a prayer to Daddy G.O. even as it turns 80. All right, now, standing by is Iyanu. Let's quickly go for a break while Iyanu stands by. Stay tuned. Welcome back. Welcome back from that break. Okay, like I said before, we're on a break. I have the social media expert. Hey, the world is going techie, and this girl is standing by. My young, beautiful lady, over to you, Iyanu.
Thank you very much. Oh my God, that's so amazing. Shaya, you mentioned something about one of the facts about Daddy, that he didn't wear shoes until he was 18 years old.
Can you imagine?
Oh my God, some of us actually, like from babies already, some of us already wearing shoes, designer shoes already. Like, how amazing is that? Anyways, my name is Iyanu Akindami, and we are on the social media segment where I will be taking your messages from all across the world. Anyways, some of you are wondering, what messages? Anyways, we decided to push out a question to celebrate our father in the Lord, Pastor Enoch Adejare Adeboye, on his upcoming 80th birthday, asking, say a word of prayer to Pastor E.A Adeboye. Well, the response we've gotten has been amazing. So we'll be looking at the comment section and to see what you guys have said about him. And our first social media platform would be on Facebook. And this is from Omowaye Bumi Precious. And it's saying, Heavenly Father will continue to grant you more divine wisdom to win more souls into the kingdom of God, and you will finish well and strong in Jesus' mighty name. Amen to that. Until the next post, we have Eunice Eloho Glory. May the Lord bless and keep you strong and healthy. I pray for fresh anointing, God's grace to finish well and strong. Love you, Bami. Guys, you know our father is going to be 80 years old. You see the strength, even at the age of 80, how we, you guys know how he works when he's going to the altar. Like, he works so majestically. And then he picks up the mic and says, somebody shout hallelujah. And anyway, still on the question, say a word of prayer to our pastor, Pastor E.A Adeboye. Do you know that our pastor still prays for us, like for all his children all around the world? You're not excluded. So what is your own prayer for him? Well, still on our Facebook platform, we have this from sorry if I'm pronouncing some of the names wrong. This is from Titi, and it's saying, Almighty God would continue to strengthen you and yours, amen. And you would finish well and strong in Jesus' mighty name. Amen to that. And our last comment on our Facebook is, God will continue to bless my daddy and the family. No more sorrow in Jesus' name. May God uphold the family to the end and more anointing to our father in Jesus' name. Amen. And moving on to our next social media platform, and that will be on Twitter. So we're reading some tweets, and this is from Ramsey, and it's saying, Father, please continue to deliver Pastor Adeboye from the hands of wicked and unreasoned people. He shall continue to be a terror to the kingdom of darkness. Bless him with good health and long life in Jesus' name. Yes, our father is going to be 90, 100, and we're going to be here to all celebrate his good wins in Jesus' name. Still on Twitter, we have this from Dayo Oderinwale, and it's saying, Lord Jesus, keep your son, Daddy G.O. and his family. Watch over them on a daily basis. Surround them with your walls of fire. Bless their lives and the ministry you have committed into their hands immensely. Help them to serve you till the end in Jesus' mighty name. Amen and amen to that. Moving on to our last platform for today is going to be Instagram, and this post is from Temitope Jeromi. More grace to you, Daddy. Amen and amen to that. And this is from Showosis. Sorry about that. Congratulations, Daddy. Long life, divine health and prosperity, peace, progress, and fulfillment of your divine assignment in Jesus' name. And our last post on our Instagram is going to be from Dorothy, and it's saying, Happy birthday, Daddy. You will live to see more fruitful and prosperous years in Jesus' name. Like I keep saying, our father is going to mark his 80th birthday on the 2nd of March, and we're going to be here to celebrate his 90th, and so on and so forth. And that is it for today on our social media segment. My name still remains Iyanu Akindayomi. And guys, please, to keep these conversations going, do not forget to use on all social media platforms, Facebook, Instagram, and on Twitter, the hashtag EAAAT. I mean, hashtag EAAAT, and I'll be right here to receive your message. I'm going to be handing it back over to Sabrina and Shia.
Alrighty. Isn't that beautiful?
Yes, very beautiful.
Thank you, Iyanu, for that. So you want to join this massive community and you want Iyanu to read your social media comments. All you have to do is go on all our social media platforms on Facebook at Dove Television, drop your comments below, and of course on Instagram at Dove TV, Twitter at Dove TV. You can also watch us live. Download the OH Prime TV on your phone. Right now, it's airing live on our Dove TV Entertainment channel on OH Prime TV. And wherever you're watching us from, all over the world, across the world, you just want to contribute and say a word of prayer. We need you. We need you to say a word of prayer to our daddy. We need you to pray for him like never before. And the Lord will strengthen you in the name of Jesus. Let's quickly go on a break because we have more fact to read. Stay tuned. Welcome back. And of course, I have Shayo still a peep into Pastor E.A. Adeboye's life. Hey, Shayo.
Hello, Sabrina.
What's up? The next fact, quickly.
How you doing?
I'm blessed.
My people. So yes, the next fact, quickly, says Daddy G.O's earliest ambition was to become the youngest vice chancellor in Africa. So you can imagine. And the funny thing is, Daddy G.O actually started school late. So imagine this. Speed that the man must have gone through to have that kind of thought, thinking in his mind. And it was going to be achieved, if not that God arrested him.
Right.
Yeah. And thank God, God arrested him, because now we have that global phenomenon that is Pastor E.A Adeboye.
Yeah. So for those, you know, there's some people that usually say to themselves that, oh, I can serve God and not go to school.
Mm-hmm.
This is not it. God wants us to prosper in all spheres of our lives. Like he said that he, above all things, he wishes that we prosper and be in good health, even as our soul prospers. So God really wants, and he said that the word of the Lord is sharper than any two-edged sword. He said that we should write our vision and make it plain that they may run and not faint. So God wants us to grasp all this wisdom and knowledge.
Mm-hmm.
You can't be a general overseer. I don't know. Should I say that? You can't take the word of God without you not even knowing a little of the word of God.
Like, take a scenario from Pastor Akindayomi.
The founder.
The founder. For those that don't know, Pastor Akindayomi is the founder of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. You know that for God to actually use him, God had to impart the knowledge of scriptures in his heart.
Mm.
So the man could not read or write at all. So it means he could not even come in contact with scripture. His story goes that he was imparted with the scripture so that he could understand that which he was reading.
Wow.
So for you to get God to move through you, you must be able to grasp certain truths, grasp certain things. And these things come from knowledge, from study, from understanding.
Mm.
So yes,
like the scripture says, study to show thyself approved.
A workman that needed not be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth.
Pastor Shayo, please lay your hands on me. All right. So his earliest ambition was to become the youngest vice chancellor in Africa. Glory be to God. The ninth fact.
Yeah, this is the month of love, so we have to be cozy about that one.
Bring your hand. And I hope your wife will not. So, Daddy, of course, beside, I don't want to say behind. Anyways, we are the neck. You people are the edge.
Beside works, behind works.
Okay, so beside our daddy, you know, we see daddy all the time. With our mommy, they're inseparable. You want to know the beautiful thing about this? Is he got married to Pastor Mrs. Folu Adeboye, our mother in Israel. Such a beautiful, phenomenal, caring. If you have not come in contact with Mommy Gio, mommy is so caring. She's the most caring woman. You cannot go to visit Mommy Gio and not get something.
She's always a blessing.
She's always
She a always blessing. Has that gift beside her that she wants to give.
Right.
Shout out to Mommy Gio.
Mommy, we love you and thank you for being a support system to our Father in the Lord, because I know you're watching right now. God bless you. We love you, Mommy. He got married to Mommy Gio in the year 1967 at the age of 25. Drum.
Bish. So it means 55 years these people have been married.
And they are still together. Our age right now. I can't do this. I want to go.
I'm tired.
I am tiring.
It's enough.
It's enough.
This place is choking me.
You know, you say we are beyond. You know, what is that word they used to say? Because I don't even want to say it.
It's not a Christian thing to say.
It's not a Christian thing. God wants us to stay together. And this, you want to see a man and a woman that have been married for more than 50 years. You want to make them a role model. This our own role model. Mm-hmm. At the age of 18, they are still waxing stronger. 55 good years that they've been married. 55. At the age of 25, daddy got married to our mommy.
And you would see that it's not an endurance kind of marriage.
Which endurance?
There's so much respect.
Love.
Have you seen them sit beside each other?
Have you seen
those,
them?
Those wonderful little conversations they have,
right.
Like Daddy Gio trying to. There was one day I saw Daddy Gio during the Holy Ghost night, and then Mommy Gio wanted to pick up her bag, but it quickly helped her. It was so beautiful.
And of course, the crossover service, when they said Happy New Year, I saw how Mommy just walked up to Daddy, and Daddy just hugged her and just placed their hand. You know, I shared. There was just. I'm not crying because of anything. I just saw the genuine love that they share.
Yeah.
You know, and Daddy just held her hand like this. I'm like, oh my God, that's.
And who are we to forget about that viral kiss?
Okay, don't worry. The next 10 one is the severe illness of their daughter led him and Mommy Gio to RCCG in the year 1973. The severe illness, and thank God they obeyed the call of Christ. We really don't want to go, but thank you all so much. These are the 10 facts we'll be looking at. 10 facts again tomorrow, 1 p.m. West African time. Knock this. And of course, I have my co-presenter. I'm sure you're enjoying yourself and getting to know all of this. Thank you all so much for joining us for the peep into our Father and the Lord, the General Overseer's life at 80. Of course, his birthday is March 2nd. Thank you all so much. And from me to you, Shayo, tell them we are wrapping up.
Okay, so we are wrapping up. You need to be here tomorrow.
Yeah.
So clear your schedule. Make sure you are on sit, waiting for this fact.
Yes.
Like Sabrina said, there may or may not be a gift attached.
We're looking at that. All right. Thank you all so much. My name is Sabrina Ozma.
And I am Olusayo Orodele.
God bless you. See you tomorrow, 1 p.m. Cheers. Bye. Bye.